Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be checking out the free assets for the month of March. Now if you are new to Unreal Engine, basically Epic Games gives away 5 free asset packs every single month. All you have to do is open up the Epic Games launcher and claim them for free, and you'll own them forever. They've been doing this for over a couple of years now, and if you collect them every single month, you'll amass a large library of free 3D assets you can use for your games or projects inside of Unreal Engine. So in this video, we'll be checking out the free assets for this month, the month of March. There's quite a bit of exciting stuff this month. Also, let me know down in the comments if I should try and make a game with these free assets like I did a couple of months ago, and if so, what type of game I should create. Now, before we get into the video, I want to give a quick shout out to my website, smartpoly.teachable.com, where you can learn how to make different types of games inside of Unreal Engine 5. I currently have a survival game course. If you guys are interested, I'll leave a link to it in the description below. And I'm actually working on remastering the course to Unreal Engine 5.4. So if you haven't purchased the course, I highly recommend you go ahead and pick it up, because I will be fully remastering the course with a lot of additional content and features. So without further ado, let's get right into the video. All right, so first up, we have this primitive characters pack. So as you can see, we have a lot of high quality primitive characters with different various outfits. So you can see we have different variations. We have the base mail right here. And of course, all the different clothing pieces are fully modular, so you can attach them to your character however you see fit. And then over here, we have many different weapons and tools that it comes with. So you can see we have different primitive axe, sword, different bone weapons, some spears, and 2 different types of staffs. Okay, so in the back here, we have more different outfits. You can see we have a female-based character and all the different clothing pieces, including the hair. It's all fully modular. And then over here, we have all the different types of characters. So these are all the preset characters with the different customizations. So we have this female character here. It reminds me of the Horizon Zero Dawn, like main antagonist. And we have this old guy here. And you can see he has sort of like this wooden leg. Okay, so we have 2 different variations of him. And then in the back, we have this other different type of design. So yeah, you can see the primitive clothing types. I really love this antlers design over here. And we'll see all of the different things that are dangling off of the antlers here, simulate physics here in a second. In the back here, we have these other different types of characters, and they have face paint. I really like the ripped cloth texture on there. Looks really nice. And of course, this guy has some different skeleton face paint there. Very detailed cloth hood and shirt. And then of course the base mesh. So yeah, all the different pieces, all the modular pieces you can see right here. So you can mix and match and really create some unique different types of characters. And then over here, again, we have all the different character variations. And then of course, in the back, I'll go ahead and hit play. And so we should see all the different animations that the pack comes with. So again, just the basic locomotion. We have idle, falling, we have jumping, running, walking, landing. Just all the basic locomotion animations that you'd expect. And some root motion, you can see walking and running. Now in the back here, I wanted to show you guys the antlers here, because they have a lot of dangly things. And they're all simulating physics, so really cool character there. And even part of the cloth here, you can see, is also has some cloth simulations. So pretty cool primitive characters pack. Again, it has modular clothing, modular pieces, and everything you need to make some sort of primitive hunter game. All right, next up we have the ultimate farming pack. Now this pack is massive. It includes a ton of different crop models for creating any sort of farming game. So over here, we're going to start at the very left. So first we have some tea leaves, so you can see the various different foliage meshes there. Then we have this hemp plant, so you can see those meshes there. We have grape, and one neat thing is you can see the different stages. So you can see this is the earlier stages, and then you can see the plant is slowly fruiting and growing. And then we have strawberry, so you can see the tiny little strawberry plants down there. So you can get all the different stages and different variations for the crop. Now parsley, see those, and mint and beet. Really cool little additions here. And they have pretty much every single crop that you can think of. So even tomatoes there, tiny little tomato plants. And here's some various different props, barrels, and crates and stuff like that. We have pepper and, I'm not going to say that, mushroom, I guess. So yeah, you can see the different models there. And then we have these different cacao trees. I'm not really sure what these are, but they look pretty cool. And we have eggplant. So you can see the little eggplant. And then over here we have cucumber and beans. So you can see little bean stalks growing. And again, it's really nice that they have the different stages. So you can see it's slowly growing up and you can see the complete fully grown plant right there. Okay. So you can add sort of like a growing over time mechanic for your game if you're adding some sort of like farming or harvesting. Okay, so we have hazel. And then we have the little spinach plants. Over here we have coffee. Okay. And so let's go over here. And so we have barley, so stage 2. Wheat, stage 2. And then we have wheat slash barley, stage 1. So you can see it's green. Not yet ready for harvest. And then, of course, the ready for harvest. Different materials on there. We have carrots. So you can see the little tiny carrots. And we have the different sunflowers. So again, you can see the tiny little plant there slowly grow to a nice big sunflower. So we have the different garlic down here and potatoes. And over here we have sugarcane, which is one of my favorites because how many survival games or farming games have sugarcane as an actual item that you can harvest? Pretty neat that they have that model in there. We have zucchini and pumpkin. So you can see a little pumpkin growing right over there. And then we have corn, right? Sort of like this corn fields. Really detailed corn model there. And the nice thing about all these meshes is they are vertex animated. So you can see that they have sort of this subtle movement in the wind. And then also another one of my favorites, cabbage and cauliflower. This looks really detailed for some reason, the texture on it. I really like that. And then we have onion. Broccoli, see the different plants there. Then we have the tobacco plant. And lastly, we have cotton. Over here, we have a couple of different more crops. So we'll go over these. So we have things like blueberries, we have different lettuce there. Not sure what plant this is, and I'm not going to try and pronounce that. We can move on. We have different berries. So you can see the different stages growing through here. I love this little frame that it comes in because it really, you know, sells a type that the player is farming or harvesting this crop. Okay, so we have peas. Let's actually zoom up real close. You can see the little peas right there. And then we have turnips, little turnip plants, and a watermelon. Looking pretty neat. Those are all the different crops. We have a couple of other things over here, different crates of vegetables and stuff like that. We have flax stage 1, flax stage 2, and then we have rice. Okay, and there's a couple of things over here. We have things like common sprouts, so you can see little sprouts. So you could use that as like the stage 1 for your crops. Then of course it comes with this nice little greenhouse. Add your little crops to grow in here. Maybe give it a little buff in your game so it grow faster if it's inside of the greenhouse. And then we have all the different land plots. So you can see we have different sizes depending on what you want. Large crop plot, extra large, this massive field. And basically you can plant the crops all along these little mounds. And let's actually check out the second level, which is a complete demo level here. I just showcase all of the crops. So you can see we have a little crop plot here with some tomatoes, some turnips there. We have some fields of wheat, other different crops here. Have some plants growing over here. I think grapes. Yep. And then we have this little greenhouse. So if you go inside the greenhouse, it has some different crops growing inside of here. Of course, if we go out again, you can see all the different fields of crops. So this would make for a really nice calm farming game, or maybe like a farming simulator where you have to harvest and tend to many different crops, depending on, you know, the various different like requirements that you need to plant and harvest different types of crops. So yeah, that is the ultimate farming pack. Let's go ahead and move on. Next up, we have this modular medieval town. So if we go ahead and full screen this, now this also includes interiors. I'm going to show you guys the overview level as it comes with all the different assets. First of all, we have this little barrel mesh, and these aren't the highest quality assets, as you can see. I mean, they would work good for a PC game, but also, you know, these are, you know, not the highest resolution or quality. So as you can see, we have some wall meshes, modular pieces. We have stuff for the interiors, like a bed, things like a wagon there, different shelves, tables, and we have all these different frames and covers, I guess you would say. And then over here, we have all the different walls, stone walls and wooden walls there. Of course, some other different props, things like wooden floors, stone floors, and some of the interior props as well. So you can see things like chairs, picture frames, stuff like that. So these buildings also come with the interior, so I'll show you that in a second. As you can see, we have stuff like the roof pieces. Then it comes with these three different trees. Again, they're not super high quality, but they work fine for lightweight sort of game. Okay, so here are the different buildings. So we have a couple of different presetted buildings. As you can see, they are already built and complete. You can start dragging and dropping them into your level. And again, they have interiors. So if I go inside of these, you can see it's very dark. So I'm gonna have to change this to unlit. Unfortunately, they didn't update the levels to Unreal Engine 5. So there's like no lighting in the inside. And let's go back down here. So you can see the different interiors there. And again, you could decorate these with props. Some of them already have some props inside of them. So if we were to go into this larger tavern sort of building, you can see that it comes with all sorts of decorations and props inside of them already set up. So we have things like tables, and it has a second level. You see that it goes all the way up here. More different types of rooms that you can decorate, like a bed in there, different barrels and stuff. And you can go all the way up the stairs into the top level floors there. So again, there's a lot of stuff you can do with these. Just completely modular, and you can mess around with them, build out any sort of medieval type game. That kind of goes hand in hand with the other different packs that we saw, like the farming and primitive characters. And it includes these demo maps. I'm not really a fan of these maps because unfortunately they don't update them for Unreal Engine 5. So it's all the old lighting. And so you can see, looks all right, but if you try and go into any of the interiors, you don't have the post process or anything set up for that. So really dark interiors, but it'll work fine if you just migrate the assets into any project and just use the default lighting. But yeah, as you can see, this is the level. So you can use some of the different buildings that they come with and create any sort of town with interiors and decorate it to your liking. All right, next up, we have this renovation simulator. So as you can see here, this is basically sort of like a house renovation game simulator. If I go ahead and hit play here, I full screen it. It's a complete game. So you can see I run around. I have this character. We have different UI on our screen. And basically you want to go ahead and repair, this house. So you can pick up different trash. So you can press F. That will go ahead and pick up different items. And you can see on the right, we have this objective. So we have, you know, garbage removal. So the more garbage that we pick up, it will complete that objective. So you can see it's 40% complete. Let's go ahead and pick up all the trash and get that quest done. So 83% complete. Leave. There's some more over here. So go pick that up. And you can see it's complete. So we have garbage removal. The next step is we need to clean up dirt. So I believe, so if you press tab, it brings up a tablet. And if you press the mouse middle button, that'll bring up a little wheel. We have different tools. So we have our hands, we have this little paintbrush, we have a hammer, we have this little brush. So I believe this is what we use to clean up the graffiti. And that says cleaning up the dirt. Okay, so that is taking care of that objective. So let's go ahead and clean up all the graffiti here and remove all that. So we're about 80% done, 100% done. And then next up, we have to repair the fences. So let's go ahead and switch to our hammer. And over here, if we left click, we'll fix that, and left click, fix that. Okay, so we fix all four of the fences. And then lastly, it wants us to sell the benches. Let's go to this, I think this is like a scanner item, like what you see in the grocery store. If we scan that, that will go ahead and sell that. And sell this bench. There's one more upstairs, but we'll leave that for later. But we can also do things like painting. If we go to our paint tab, if we open up our tablet, we can go to paint, and we can choose different paint types. So let's say I want to paint red. Now that I have selected, I can go ahead and paint the walls. So you can see I can paint the walls up here. Maybe that is actually too high. That's kind of strange. I can't actually paint high enough. You can change the different colors. So you can see I can select yellow. And it's compiling shaders there because this is my first time selecting these different colors. You can see that it has a little checkered. It's because it has a compile. As you can see, we can paint the walls different colors. We can actually change the floor as well. So if we go to floors, we can select the different floors. Right now, you only see there's wood. If I change this to wood, it's kind of weird that you use the paintbrush tool to paint floors wood. They could have added, you know, a different tool that you use for the floor, and even have things for ceilings. We have plaster. So go in here, there's some ceilings. So we can plaster, I guess, the ceiling like so. You have to stand directly underneath it to get it. And what else? We have things like walls, decorations. So if you wanted to put up like a wallpaper, I guess. And yeah, that's pretty much the simulator. We have a basic pause menu. Resume, options. Doesn't look like any of this is actually set up, but we can click resume. And let's go ahead and actually finish the last objective here. So if I switch on my wheel, my little scanner, clean that up, you can see that we completed all the objectives. So I don't think there is anything that happens after you complete it all. But yeah, just a very basic renovation simulator game. Has a very basic game loop. So you can see you have to complete the objectives. You have a little tablet where you can select paint types, different wall types, floors, and all that stuff. And so just a very basic bare bones template. And obviously you could build upon it, add your own different types. And it looks like it even has a little daytime simulator. But yeah, you can see all the different blueprints. So if I go out of here, you can see we have things like BP wall, BP ceiling, the different fences. So if you wanted to, you could go in and add your own different meshes or make your own different levels using some of these different assets, okay? So pretty neat little blueprint game there. And that's pretty much all of the asset packs. Lastly, we have this plugin called DLC in Blueprints. Basically, this little plugin allows you to unlock certain content based on if the player has purchased DLC, whether that be Steam DLC or Epic Game Store DLC. So basically it supports either or. It's just a very simple system to unlock certain content based on the DLCs that you have set up. Even includes stuff like opening up a store page if the player hasn't purchased the DLC. So we'll go ahead and open up in a web browser your game store page so that the player can go ahead and purchase it, unlock it, and download the DLC. So I'm not going to really cover over this. You guys can check it out, but it's a very simple blueprint-based plugin that you can use to add things like DLC to your game. Now, those are all 5 free asset packs that we get for this month. Let me know which one is your guys' favorite down in the comments down below. Personally, I like the Ultimate Farming Pack because there was a lot of high-quality crop models and many different crop types. So there's a lot of variation with that. And you can make a really nice farming game, farming simulator with all that stuff. But let me know which one was your favorite down in the comments down below. Also, should I try and attempt to make a game with these 5 free asset packs? If so, let me know what type of game I should make. I'm thinking maybe sort of like a primitive farming simulator game where you have, you know, your primitive characters, have your medieval village buildings in the background, and then you have your farming plot where you have to follow the various different objectives to plant different crops and harvest them before the time runs out. But yeah, let me know what you guys think down in the comments down below. And of course, make sure you pick up these 5 free asset packs before the month ends. Check out my courses on my website, smartpoly.teachable.com, if you want to learn how to make different types of games. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.